Hey y'all,
it's been a while since I've done a vlog. That big old building back there behind me, that's my church. That's Lakewood Church. Yeah, like Joel Osteen Church. So since it has been a while since I've done any vlogging because of homework, I thought I would share a story with y'all about how I found out that people falling out in church is a real thing. So if you watch exaggerated, probably black folk movies, stereotypical movies, or if you watch like anything about revivals and whatnot, occasionally you see people just get knocked out, quote unquote, by the Holy Spirit. Okay, I'm a God-fearing person. You all know that I profess my faith with no shame, and I thought that that was a hoax. I'm like, okay, you know what, people just get too caught up in the antics of all of this. Not my life. I may cry in service. In fact, I cry quite often because the songs are beautiful and I get all emotional. I didn't cry tonight. But that I wasn't buying. I refuse to believe that. Like, are you serious? Everything is just so intense that you just can't handle anything and you fall out? Fine, whatever. Years ago, in that big building, I went to a Friday night service for something called Celebrate Recovery. Celebrate Recovery is for those of us who are dealing with things that are relatively difficult, and we decide to challenge it not just by ethical matters and medical matters in some cases, but we also want to challenge it with our faith. Well, I didn't have an addiction, although there were some people who do have that, and that happens. I had other things I was struggling with and wanted to work through. Well, we go. We have our usual cookies and juice. I'm going through the motions. We sing the songs. Now, Lakewood Church has a, like, bomb choir. The only choir, like, better than that would be Hillsong. So, I'm going through the motions. I'm singing my songs and whatnot. La, 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 la. We go ahead and start the sermon. Going through our stuff. Now, let's back up. You see my hair. You all see my hair on the regular. More often than not on my channel, my hair's not done. Why? Because I roll around with people's children Monday through Friday. Now when I have to travel and do appearances, I'll be looking right. Not so much when it's just Monday through Friday, because I'm not about to have little Jimmy put Play-Doh in my hair if it's late and I'm looking flat. It's just not gonna work. But that particular service, I had a new gorgeous wig because I live for wigs. If I had the money to have a custom collection, I surely would. Uh-oh, almost dropped a phone. I surely would. I live for them. They're thebomb.com. So I had on a new, illustrious, beautiful wig. And we are going through the motions, singing and whatnot. We do the sermon, and then they ask people to come up to the altar for prayer. Okay, that was my plan. I'ma come on up there and get, you know, my Jesus pieces, which is communion. If you kind of new to my channel, I've mentioned Jesus pieces before. But okay, I'm coming to get my Jesus pieces, and then I need you to put, you know, prayer on me and whatnot. So we start praying, and I feel the pastor lift his hand up over my wig, I mean over my head. And I'm like, what is he doing? And we talking and praying and all that good stuff. Then I get to murmuring, which is just weird to me up here, but not in here. So my brain is going, what is happening? What is happening? But I'm still murmuring. Apparently that's speaking in tongues, something new to me. Again, I said, I believe in all of this. I just had a limited belief in all of that. So my brain is flipping out a little bit, but I'm feeling it. I'm saying something. I'm legitimately saying something. And the pastor did one little tap right here. It wasn't even hard. It wasn't a pop. It wasn't a flick like if he was mad at somebody. He just laid a hand here. I was out like a light. And I felt my wig come off, but I couldn't do anything. I couldn't put my hand above my head to pull it back down or nothing. I was laid out by the Spirit and my wig was off. I literally lost my wig in church. Oh God, sorry, it just dawned on me that that's what happened. I got my wig snatched in the sanctuary. Oh, so yeah, when I came to, which was sometime later. It was other people on the float too, not everybody, it was like maybe four of us. But I felt like I had a great nap. I felt very refreshed. I felt like all my pain had been left at the altar. Life did start to turn around after that, but I definitely changed my opinion about laughing at people when that happens, because I really should have hit like a pew or something, a chair. Nope. No, I just lost my hairstyle. All right, I'm going home now. That was my story. I'll vlog again. I don't know if it's going to be tomorrow. I do know Friday is like lit because it's Ask Ashley on Facebook, and then it's the McGuilas chat. And then this weekend, I'll be in Minnesota for the K-pop festival. And if you live in Minnesota and you want free tickets, you need to go back a few videos and look at my promo video for it. But yeah, that's about it. Nope, no vlog tomorrow, I don't think. Unless something crazy happens. It seems like all my vlogs are turning into story times now. Whatever, y'all love it. Bye, y'all.